Hey guys, I'm Cubeoid, and this is my RotaryCraft tutorial series, episode 4. This one's 4. And in this episode, I'm going to be showing how to make ethanol, the machines required to make it, and what machines use it, or one of the main machines that uses it. Okay, so let's just get into it. So the first machine you're going to want to make is the fermenter, and this thing, just turn off any eye there, okay, so this thing requires 4 steel ingots, 4 base panels, and 1 impeller, and it looks pretty good, kind of looks like a, I don't know, steel furnace with a hole on the back. Yeah. This is actually the 4th time recording this. I have gone through this so many times, because the first time it didn't record for some reason. The second time, I forgot something because RotaryCraft updated, and the other time it didn't record any sound, so I hope it's doing all of those things now, but yeah, never mind now, let's just continue. So second of all, this thing has an alternate recipe, so instead of using steel ingots, you can replace those 4 steel ingots with 4 tin ingots. Again, RotaryCraft does not have its own ores, you will require another ore, another mod to supply the tin. And the reason it had ingots was because of the grinder over there. Okay, so how to use the fermenter. So you're going to want some things first. You're going to want some dirt, some sugar, and some sort of plant matter. So whether that's grass or flowers or rainbow saplings. I don't think canola seeds work, but I know leaves work, saplings work, and you know, I'll go through all of them later. So what you want to do first of all is you want to put your sugar up in the top slot and your dirt in the bottom. And if I actually turn the thing on, this thing only requires a DC electric engine to work. I have my sound insulation to keep it. And here I just have it, but speed it up with a 16:1 gearbox. You could use a wood one if you want, but I use that one. And I put sound insulation around the steam engines, but because there's a fire under them, the wood would light on fire. So I covered every side of the wood in glass, so it couldn't catch on fire. Like, if you take away the wool, there's a definite difference. So, yeah. Same with the electric engine. The electric engine's loud. This doesn't have a fire, so. See, here it goes. If you have it like this, it won't work. So you have to have it like this. Sugar at the top, dirt in the bottom, water in the middle. Well, just supply water to the thing using a liquid pipe. Or I suppose you could bucket it in. But, yep. And that gives you yeast, so it's like this. And how to make... Now the thing... It's kind of loud, but... The thing required to make this, the yeast, into the stuff used to make ethanol, requires you to put the yeast on the top and your some sort of plant matter at the bottom. And if you want to automate it, you can apply a redstone signal and it'll change the automation to sludge, but you don't actually need to do that, I found. And there you go. Sludge. Now I'll just show you doing it faster. You can make it that way as well. But as not all plants are the same, see here. So like if I use fir leaves, I get 2. Leaves can be 2. Shimmering saplings can be 12. Potatoes 1. Sapling leaves 2. So you can see there's just a whole bunch. See, silverwood saplings give you 32, but that's all. Silverwood leaves, why does it have it in twice, gives you 64. So, yes, we can just put ever want to use a fermenter, use the silverwood sap, use the silverwood leaves. I mean, I know they're kind of rare in the game, and you want them to farm craft things, but if you can't spare some leaves, might as well use it to make some sludge. And now, the thing that you put the ethanol in is a gasoline engine, and I'll show you how to craft that. So it has multiple different pieces that are just crafted in crafting stations. First one is the piston. You get two of these per crafting recipe. It requires 8 HSLA steel ingots in kind of like the chest shape around in the center of the crafting grid. You're also going to need an ignition unit. 2 gold, 5 steel ingots, and 1 redstone gives you 1 ignition unit. It has an alternate recipe, which can replace the gold with electrum. I don't know why you'd want to do that. It's harder to get electrum because you got to grind silver and gold into powder, but yeah. And how to make the actual gasoline engine requires 2 pistons. Luckily, the piston recipe gives you 2. It requires 1 ignition unit, 2 steel plates, 1 impeller, a 2x gear unit, and shaft, as well as a gold ingot. I may have said that already, but I said it again, whatever. And it gives you a gasoline engine. The thing looks pretty good. It has shaft on the front. Gold piece on top. Yep. And now, before I show you what to do with that, I will show you how to turn the sludge into ethanol. And you used to just be able to put the sludge into a furnace and cook it up into ethanol crystals, but now you gotta make yourself a centrifuge. Now, before I forget these things here, this is also a good time to show how to make the beveled gears. I should have shown how to make these earlier at some point, but I'm showing them now, whatever. So, to make bevel gears in a work table, you need 5 base panels, 1 HSLA steel gear, 2 shaft units, and 1 HSLA steel ingot. That gives you 4 beveled gears. Why did I do that? Okay, well, whatever. I was going to show it. I should have just taken them out of there, but had to use them. So you place it down, and these can pretty much let you change the direction of a shaft. You can choose the input and output, and so I believe that weighs north, right? Yep. And so you can choose the input side to be north, and the output side to be up. And you can see power goes in there or come out there. You can also choose the output side to be down, or west, or east, or that can choose south to be the input, and all sorts of stuff. And the centrifuge is made by putting a 4x gear unit at the bottom, putting 2 base panels beside that, 2 HSLA steel up either side, so 4, and 1 glass pane at the top that gives you 1 centrifuge. And that thing takes power in from the bottom. So that's what you need to use the bevel gears for. So I believe this one's set to input yeast, output up. And just a normal steam engine, which is what I have in there, will not power this, so you need to make it spin faster using a gearbox. I just used a 16:1 gearbox for that, but so it will go fastest. You could use a wood one if you wanted, or instead of a steel one, but yep. So what you do is you take your sludge, you plop it in the centrifuge, and you let it go. Now, I'll just show you the info tab for the centrifuge. You can pause the video now if you want to read this. And, okay, you have read it. You can also use the this to separate the combs from forestry. Instead of using the centrifuge and forestry, but put that in there. You let it kind of tick up its thing. Come on. Alright. And there we go. So we got 2 ethanol extract. Should be used for this. So the centrifuge, this can give, when you put it in the centrifuge, you have an 80% chance of getting an ethanol extract, another 20% chance of getting an ethanol extract, and a 25% chance of getting a compost each time this thing goes through. So, yeah. See, there's a compost. For the compost, you can, in a crafting recipe, you can pretty much combine it with sand to get dirt. use your ethanol extract. It doesn't have a texture right now, it seems. It's just those purple things, but it'll have a texture eventually probably. Just plop this in your furnace, and you'll get your ethanol extract. Technically, the new way of making the ethanol is better than the old one, because I think it's better because it adds an extra step in there. So it kind of forces you to make the centrifuge, which can then be used to further produce something. I'll show you. But here's your ethanol crystals, and you can pretty much tell that's kind of a weird look for the sky. The color of the sky does not kind of match the brightness on the ground. Okay, you pretty much take the ethanol crystals and you plop them in the gas in the engine. That's very loud, but you can hear it going. If you remember from the last episode, the grinder, you can grind canola seeds into canola seed husks. Well, these things can be further processed inside the centrifuge for more canola. So you can just let it go. It doesn't process too fast. I mean, you can make it spin faster if you probably replace the steam engine I'm using with the gasoline engine. There you go, so we've got 90 lubricant. It's just a good way to use these canola seed husks, because the only other thing you can do is combine them with yeast, the composter, which I haven't shown yet, to make seed husks. Or you can use them here to get 90 for. So, yeah. And I think that will. Let's go to something quieter. So, I think that will end this episode of my RotaryCraft tutorial series, and see you in the next one.